Hello, I'm Shukran Nakati, a technical marketing engineer here at Infoblox. In this video, we are going to take a look at the Infoblox BloxOne Splunk plugin. With rapid modernization, adoption of cloud, hybrid workforce, and IoT, security challenges have increased multifold in the recent years. Some statistics shown here are proof of just how complex SecOps has become. Security teams typically get more than 500 alerts a day and can investigate only a fraction of those. Too many siloed tools and long threat containment times result in increased risk to the business. DNS, DHCP, and IPAM are critical components of network management and play a key role in IP address management, device management, and network configuration. DDI provides visibility into network and security events, and this helps organizations better manage their network infrastructure. The Infoblox BloxOne Splunk plugin provides valuable insights into the network, boosts visibility to network and security events, and allows the users to monitor their network's usage and security. The plugin is available on Splunk Base and can be downloaded and installed from there. The plugin comes with predefined dashboards that provide users with a high-level view of their network's data and allow them to quickly see their network metrics in a single place. The predefined dashboards show insights into security activity, DNS, DHCP, Tide, and Dossier. Let's see how the plugin and its dashboard look in a live environment. The instance that we are going to see is already configured. If you need help with the configuration, there is a link to the deployment guide in the video description. Once you are within your Splunk instance and have installed Infoblox BloxOne, it should appear in the application list. Clicking on it opens it up, and the security events dashboard opens by default. This dashboard provides a detailed view of the security-related activities on the network, including insights about devices, threat indicators, threat classes, and other useful metrics. Additionally, the dashboard includes various charts displaying different metrics such as events over time, events by indicators, feed, severity, and others. Each dashboard also has a couple of filters that you can use to get the desired output. In this dashboard, we have the time period, thread feed category, domain, and client device filters. Clicking on the BloxOne dashboard menu reveals a list of dashboards available. Next on the list is the DNS events dashboard. This dashboard provides a detailed view of the DNS activity on the network, including information on DNS queries and responses. It also includes data on top domain names, top clients, events over time, and others. The next dashboard on the list is the DHCP overview. This dashboard shows DHCP activity on the network, including information on DHCP requests and leases. It also features a chart showing the DHCP events over time. After that, we have the B1TD filter hits dashboard. This provides information about the queries that match the filters set up in BloxOne, such as application, category, and custom filters used in the BloxOne portal. Next is the events by queries and source IP dashboard. This gives users a closer look into the queries and their origin. Apart from these, the plugin also includes Tide and Dossier dashboard. The Tide dashboard provides insight about the data indexed from Infoblox Threat Intelligence Data Exchange Service, including the number and types of threat indicators, indicators over time, and the detail about threat level, confidence, and score. Next up is the Dossier dashboard. This provides detailed information about the selected indicator, with a link to the BloxOne Dossier summary page for the selected indicator. This allows users to quickly gather information and take necessary actions to prevent threats. Thank you for your time viewing this video. All documentation regarding BloxOne is available on the Infoblox documentation website, located at docs.infoblox.com. If you have any other concerns, questions or comments, you can reach out to the Infoblox experts on the Infoblox community website, located at community.infoblox.com.